This you're going to see has been the view for many drivers today. Our mobile weather lab has been traveling through the heavy rain in Butler County with some of the heaviest rain along Route 422 between Moraine State Park and the city of Butler. So what exactly is the reason for all of the severe weather in the first few months of this year? John Shumway is live now with some answers. John?
Yeah, Stacy, it's been a pretty intense day of weather around here in the last, about 8 hours or so, especially the last three or four. By the way, we are on Route 8, about 9 to 10 miles south of the city of Butler right now. You can see how intense the rain is and the water pooling off to the side. But after the weekend that we've had, especially seeing the storms in Ohio and those that happened to the west, I went to our two meteorologists to ask them what the heck is going on.
The devastation across the country is heartbreaking, and it just keeps on coming day after day, from Oklahoma to Ohio so far, all thanks to a subtropical jet stream.
A line of very strong and powerful winds that generally is hovering a couple of thousand feet above us.
That pumps in the moisture, pumps in the heat, and if you've walked outside today, you've noticed the moisture, you notice the heat.
Those are the ingredients mixing into powerful winds, which creates lift.
And the lift is what creates thunderstorms. Intense lift can intensify those thunderstorms and can lead to even worse, like tornadoes.
The line of the jet stream above is visible in the track of the devastation, even here in Pennsylvania.
I believe we're up to 18 across the state so far this year. Normally our busiest time of the year is June and July, and we haven't even gotten there, yet we've already hit our yearly average with tornadoes, which is 16.
Our meteorologists say a high pressure system baking the south is holding all of this in place. The good news, the elements that caused all the damage in Ohio and points west are moving this way, but...
And those air masses modify a little bit as they go from west to east, so we wouldn't expect something quite like that. Something quite like that is rare here. It has happened.
And the threat should subside after Thursday. That said, if a tornado is sounded for your area,
that means getting to the inside or the safest part of your home, getting to a low level in your house, and waiting out that storm.
Away from windows with as many walls between you and the storm as you can get. And as for taking pictures, this is not the flat Midwest where storms can be seen for miles.
And if you can see a tornado touching the ground here, you are too darn close to it.
Yeah, and one more word of caution about the storms we are getting. This rain is so intense. Pooling of water on the roads is happening. We saw it as we were coming through the town of Butler and people driving through it without thinking twice. You know, the old adage is don't drive in the water. Stay out of that because you have no idea exactly how deep it is. But these intense storms certainly get your attention and it makes you slow down. Thank goodness. Live on Route 8 in Renfrew, John Shumway, KDKA News.